To mod Modern Warfare 2, Spec Ops, and single player campaign online. Basically, you can mod with friends on Spec Ops, and you can play single player without being disconnected from Xbox Live. This might be a bit of a late tutorial, don't really worry about it. So the things you're going to need is this folder right here. Well, you'll get this one. But in it, you'll get these three right here. Inside of the filter, you'll get that. You will need Horizon. If you don't know where to get that, I'm not going to be posting the link for it. Just type in Horizon Modding Tool download, and there should be one on Google. You can type up. It's not that big of a deal, you know. You can find it all over the internet. It's free. Don't worry about doing surveys. There's no surveys for it. Some Xbox scene.com or something like that. I don't really know. But it's on one of those Xbox websites. And you're going to need to go to the download link, obviously. This is what it will bring up. Yes, it's MediaFire. Don't worry about those stupid surveys. And that's about it. So what you're going to want to do is open up Horizon. And open up that Xbox font. Open up the save game. And you're gonna wanna look at the README basically. If you can, if you, you know, don't really have to, it's right here. It just tells you who it's made by and everything. This was not made by me, it was made by someone else. If there's a buy menu, it gives you a mod menu. The control scheme is also here. Then we've got the save game. What you want to do is drag that save game into your Horizon. It's laggy. Hold up. Got a slow computer. Sorry about that. Yeah, so it's loading. There's my profile. It already loaded up because I saved it. Onto it. Okay, so, and then also what you're gonna need is a thumb drive. I forgot to tell you. I'll put a list of everything that you'll need in the description. So, let me get my thumb drive. So, I plugged my thumb drive into the computer, and it's gonna bring up this. It's loading for it. You know, waiting, trying to see if everything's in there. And I don't really have a. You don't really need that big of a thumb drive. So, if you don't already have it already, make sure you have an old save game for Modern Warfare. Just bring it onto the thumb drive. So, once you have that, let's see. The Modern Warfare 2 save game. If you don't have one, that's fine. I've got two for two different accounts. But if you've had Horizon and you have your gamer profile as a favorite, you can just go to here to change. If you have like a Call of Duty World at War or some type of save game already on it, you can go to manage and look for the profile. It should bring it up. Like I've got my gamer tag as a favorite and another gamer tag of mine that's a favorite. So I can have these two modding. So, like I said, you just click on it. If you do not know how to, you know, let's say if you do have a Modern Warfare 2 and you don't have it as favorite or anything, what you do is you take a Modern Warfare 2 save game, put it on your thumb drive. Once you put it on your thumb drive, you put that save game like this. You go like this, drag it into, oh, okay, there we go. Now it should work. Now you drag it into there, And what you do is you take the profile ID, the device ID, and the console ID, copy each one of those, and put those numbers into the modded save game. Like, as you can see, mine look a little bit different, but they're mostly the same thing, because the console ID and the profile ID are the exact same. Device ID doesn't have to be exactly the same, but make sure you copy and paste it just in case. And then you want to exit out of this one after you copy and paste all the IDs into here. Click on Save to the Device, Flash Drive, Save Changes Before Transferring, and then a little message to say, you know, Save to Device. It says, would you already fix on the device? Armor for 2 save game already exist. Would you like to override it? You can click on Yes, or if you just extracted it and deleted it already, don't worry about it. Just as long as you transfer and override it, you're good. Now this will overwrite your original with the mod game, so you will never have the original game, unless you like you backed up on your computer or something. So after you've done that, I'm going to exit out of this, you know, minimize this or whatever. And then you want to go on your Xbox, and what you do is you go to single player, go to thumb drive, or wherever you put the modded save game, click on it on the save device, then go to resume game. And then it should load up like the first mission or something. And you should have like a little green square in the center. Press start, save and quit, and then go to Spec Ops. Once you go to Spec Ops, you go to 2 online multiplayer, like for the Spec Ops multiplayer online or something like that. You click on that, but before you click on a map, you press B, and it should bring you up to your private match or something. And then you invite a friend, then you start it up, then it should work. That's the only way to get it to actually work. You should have a checkerboard when you press the back button. I will put a part 2 in this video. It's going to be another link. It'll be a link in the description that'll show me going through this step on how to get it to work. So yeah, guys, rate, comment, subscribe. If you need help with other video, I'll post another video to show you guys. Thanks.